Premier Su Tseng-chang has announced that the high-speed rail line will be extended to Pingtung. The exact route is still under discussion, but it will be expensive in every case, with the cheapest plan costing 61.9 billion NT.
The question front and center is it worth it?
Well, Premier Su believes it's absolutely worth it, as the bullet train would pay off toward the long-term development of the country.
Scholars disagree. We give you both sides of the debate in today's Sunday special report.
It's Friday night. Throngs of people pour into Taipei Main Station. For the Hsiao siblings, it's the start of a long expedition. After an hour and a half on the high-speed rail, they arrive at Zuoying Station in Kaohsiung. But their journey is far from over. Xiao Ming-hsiao and Xiao Fang-ching walk toward the Xinzuoying railroad station. A half hour on the train and a 10-minute ride in the family car later, the siblings are finally home. It is now midnight. An exhausting trek that takes over 3 hours. That's the fastest way home for Pingtung natives who work in Taipei. A better alternative is coming soon. The Ministry of Transportation and Communications plans to build a bullet train station in Pingtung.
This land behind me is Taiwan Sugar Corporation's Liu Kuaizuo farmland. The Transportation Ministry's Railway Bureau is considering using this site for a Pingtung bullet train station. Those who haven't gone out to the countryside before wouldn't be able to understand. Medical care, education, business, regional development, these are all chronic pain points for the people of Pingtung.
According to the Transportation Ministry's feasibility study, a bullet rail link to Pingtung would see about 4,000 to 5,500 passengers a day and generate revenue reaching 1.3 billion NT a year. An expert says that's an optimistic estimate.
After extending the high-speed railway to Pingtung, they still have to set up a shuttle system for the 830,000 people living in Pingtung. It's not like you build it and all 830,000 people will come. They won't. Why? Because the people living in Donggang and Linbian could go to Zuoying Station, and that would take less time than going to this new place.
A Pingtung bullet train station would struggle to compete with Zuoying Station, which is already well connected via shuttle buses, trains, and even an express service to Kunding. Experts say a Pingtung HSR would be of marginal benefit for locals as well as tourists. Down south, local officials argue that public infrastructure has to advance public interest and not merely financial gain.
If public investment decisions were guided only by economic benefits or short-term profitability and not by the contribution to long-term national planning, then the government has no need to exist. We believe that the project, in its original scope, can drive value of at least 60 billion NT in regional development. Transport infrastructure is a necessary condition for economic development. It's not a sufficient condition. Let's say that Pingtung has built up a certain industry. You have to see what industry it is. Is all the manpower coming in from outside Pingtung? If a transportation project is designed to create jobs in Pingtung, then its services should meet the needs of the people in Pingtung itself. The Taiwan Railways Administration provides basic services to Pingtung residents. Why is it that we keep trying to finance convenient services and yet disregard basic services?
One scholar thinks that if the trip to Pingtung is slow, the problem is with the TRA.
The TRA's operations are really very inefficient. Let's say I want to transfer from the HSR to the rail at Xinzuoying Station in Taichung. Sometimes I have to wait for 15 to 20 minutes. It's like going from heaven to hell.
As part of its forward-looking infrastructure development program, the government has earmarked more than 200 million NT to add trains to the Zuoying Pingtung section. Nevertheless, the people of Pingtung still yearn for the day when a bullet train rides up to their town. Perhaps at the core, it's a longing for equality.
Back in 1977, Taiwan's first freeway opened up and ended at Fengshan in Kaohsiung, failing to cross the Kaoping River into Pingtung. Railway electrification began in 1979, but to this day, the electrification project in Pingtung is still not complete.
Four proposals are on the table for the Pingtung extension. At a meeting at the end of the month, the Transport Ministry will evaluate the proposals and possibly reach a decision. The Railway Bureau says that if the most favored proposal clears its environmental assessments and obtains its land permits on time, the HSR could arrive in Pingtung as early as 2031.